Scotland is blessed with abundant natural resources, which we can use to source our energy. As such, it is vital that Scotland leads in the global transition to renewable energy that sees us put an end to our addiction to dirty and expensive fossil fuels, which are damaging the climate. But as much as this transition relies on renewable energy technology, it is also crucial that people across the country support it. Community ownership of renewable energy projects generates public support whilst ensuring that the benefits go to everyone, not just a handful of large energy companies. From remote island grids to urban solar co-ops, this film explores community power in Scotland. The film will examine 6 case studies of people across Scotland making use of the main renewable energy sources, wind, hydro and solar. It will look at the advantages of community energy projects and the need to put people and the environment at the heart of a renewable energy transition. It will also examine the potential barriers to creating community power projects and how people overcome these challenges. Hi, my name is Anne, and my ambition is for others to share the same passion for community power that I have. I've seen firsthand the benefits to people when they come together and use local sources of abundant renewable energy. So please join me now on my journey across Scotland to see how community energy projects can and are making a difference. Our journey begins by travelling from Edinburgh to the town of Kinghusie in the Highlands to witness the launch of the Kinghusie Hydro project.
Of construction of the Kinghusie Community Hydro, which is a restoration of a project that was built almost 100 years ago. So to have it actually starting today is a big day for us.
The main purpose of this project is to generate power for the community, and if the water wasn't there we wouldn't be here today starting this project.
Electricity from here will be sold to the local golf club, which is behind me up the road. So there's a benefit to them as well as a community organisation, as well as a benefit to us. The KCDC, which is a local community charity, will receive an income which will then be used for charitable purposes within Kinghusie.
Today is a great day really, because we're starting the actual construction of the project. And one of the big costs to the golf club was in the ever-increasing electricity bills at this old clubhouse behind you here. And the opportunity to link it with the Strathlin project just a couple of hundred yards down the road here was one that seemed too good to miss. So over the past couple of years we've reached the stage of coming to an agreement with KCDC to buy the electricity at a reduced cost in comparison to what we pay the energy companies. And it's nice to see a couple of community organisations basically working together for the benefit of everyone who uses the village and uses the golf club as a centre of their leisure activities.
We next travel to Knockbane Farm in Dingwall to view the on-site construction of the Dingwall Wind Co-op's wind turbine.
I'm Richard Lockett. I'm one of the founders of the Dingwall Wind Co-operative, and today we're finally at last building the wind turbine. Dingwall Wind Co-operative was set up last year in 2013, where we ran a share offer and local people bought shares in this turbine. So there's about 180 members of the cooperative, all of whom own a share in this turbine that's being built today. We've had a lot of rain, so that's made things a bit more challenging with the roads and access and stuff. I suppose the main benefit is we're generating renewable electricity. That's probably the biggest thing. But also the fact that other people who previously hadn't had an involvement with wind energy developments have got more, you know, got more involvement, more at stake and more interest, and can come up here and see this turbine turning and say that they had a part of it. I think that's really positive.
My name's Mark Cutting, and I'm from Mosscliffe Environmental. This is by far the greenest environmentally friendly approach. The nuclear is not everyone's favourite. Coal's running out. I don't personally feel it's a great blot on the landscape. I think it's quite pleasant to look at, and it gives people green energy. So I think it's the way to go.
Hi, I'm Miles, and I've got involved with the wind turbine here. So I've been around the farm for many years. It ticked a lot of boxes for me, the fact that it's community owned, it's a good use of a little bit of land, and also there's some of the profits made from the generating electricity goes into a community fund, so even those who couldn't afford to buy shares in the co-op, they can access the profits that the turbine makes. We obviously hope that our shareholders are kept happy and the turbine makes a profit over the 20 years and helps help Scotland to be a leader in generating energy from renewable source. Initially there was probably a few objections to the planning, but there always is with wind turbines, but the objections were totally matched by the support from the local people. So we're very lucky that that's how it all came about.
I'm David Lockett. This is Knockbane Farm, where I've been since 1971. And this is the first time, certainly in this local area, where there's been an opportunity for local people to have a wind turbine of their own. We thought it'd be a good idea to at least attempt to start a wind cooperative which might be funded locally. And we're very lucky that that's been very successful. The main thing is that local people can get a financial benefit from something that they're going to live with for the next 20 years. I would like to see the various cooperative projects in Scotland that are nearly in at completion stage, see them be successful, and then of course people will hopefully follow, and it'll become a more common way of doing this sort of thing. And let's hope that is the case.
Next up on our journey, we travel to the Isle of Egg to visit Egg Electric, who successfully run a standalone electricity grid.
This is the first time this system was ever put together in the world.
Mm.
And until we switched it on here, they didn't know that it would work.
Having the three different types of
renewables going in together, yeah. They come in here in direct current and it's converted. This is a rectifier that turns it to AC. Then it goes into the transformer out there. If there's too much power, we've got a series of heaters in public spaces like the community hall,
okay.
The two churches, down at the peer centre. Here, at the last resort, there's 4 6-kilowatt heaters. If there was a power cut, it means that these don't have to stop, that they carry on producing and throw it away. The hydro, like I was saying earlier on, is very clever. That's got a governor. Yeah. If the frequency goes up above, I think it's 91.7, the governor comes in and diverts water away.
We have a small hydro just a couple of yards away from the house, which was installed in 2003, which has now become part of the main system. It's amazing because we have 24-hour power, don't have to worry about switching the generator on in the morning, switching it off at night, no lights for the guests overnight, also just the hassle of ordering diesel from the mainland and getting it taken over, getting it from the pier to here, putting it in the tank, you know, making sure it doesn't run out. It's so much easier. If it's a business, I have 10 kilowatt here. And if it's a domestic property, they have up to 5 kilowatt. We have this little gadget called an owl, which measures the consumption of our energy in each property. So when you're getting to near your limit, an alarm goes off to let you know that you're getting close to.
The next stage of our tour of Scotland brings us to the town of Neilston, where we learn more about the Neilston Community Wind Farm.
So what was the motivation for you to get involved in the Community Energy Project?
As a development trust, we were trying to raise money as part of our regeneration of the village. And we saw the wind farm as a way of doing that without expending all our energy trying to raise money. This is an easy way, if you like, of raising that cash. Rather than the money from the wind farm going all to the developers and large companies, it's actually going to come into the community itself. We'll be able to spread that money and use it within the community.
Do you have any specific projects? What are you using it for?
We have a town charter.
Yeah.
Where we spoke to the village and got a list of projects that we'd like to spend the money on, and we'll use it for those projects. There's a lot of argument about whether or not the output is always there, because if the wind doesn't blow, then there's no energy. So if you can actually find a way of storing that energy and then even out the supply.
What are the plans for the future now that it's here?
Well, actually just start getting the money in and start to spend it, and we're just about to start a project just now where we're looking at the village centre, how we're going to regenerate that, and the money that comes along in a few years' time from the wind farm will help us grow that out.
The penultimate stage of our journey takes us to South Lanarkshire, where we are given an insight into the spirit of Lanarkshire Wind Energy Co-op.
The Spirit of Lanarkshire is an energy cooperative that has a share in a couple of projects in South Lanarkshire. And what the cooperative does is allows ordinary people in South Lanarkshire and beyond to have a stake in a renewable energy project. So the people of South Lanarkshire own two wind farms. We think that's terrific, because that means that people get a share of the profit from energy. And we think it's important that not just the big corporations get that profit, the people should get that profit and the community should get that profit. Through this project, we actually have some power. We have a degree of control over what happens with some of the money that is derived from this project. So for us, it's about turning that around, investing in community. And over the next 25 years, we hope to invest a considerable sum of money in the community of South Lanarkshire. And we believe we will benefit from that as a group of people, as the people of South Lanarkshire. The way the scheme operates is we've actually bought a share of the profits. We don't actually own either project. We have done that as a cooperative movement in the past, but we found it very expensive indeed and very risky. So the developer has taken all the risk. The developer has built the project. The developer has gone for planning permission. All we are doing is sharing in the profit of the developer. So for us, that is the best way to do it. It means we don't have the operating responsibility. It means that we don't have many of the risks that the developer takes. But at the same time, we're involved in a project that can produce the electricity of Scotland. So for us, that's terrific. People of South Lanarkshire, and indeed people across Scotland, can invest their own money in this and get a pretty decent return. We're talking about 8.5%. Not guaranteed, but that's what the figures that we have suggest. Now, you can't get that at the moment in the banks in any form whatsoever. So we think it's a good opportunity for people to invest for the future, for themselves, for their children, and for their grandchildren. But also, we are investing in a different way of producing electricity. It's not just about money. It's also about how, in 20, 25 years, our children and our grandchildren receive fuel, not from carbon, we hope, but from renewable sources. So we think over the next 25, 30, 40, 50 years, society will find all sorts of ways to invest in renewable energy. This is just the start. This is in some ways the easy bit. We believe in time to come that all our energy will come this way, and we will be able to say we were there at the start.
Our journey finishes back in Edinburgh, where we are introduced to the Edinburgh Community Solar Cooperative.
We are a group of individuals who are working with the Edinburgh City Council to put solar panels on public buildings. And the idea is that we invite the people of Edinburgh to invest their money and become members of the co-op and own solar panels. It's all about people engaging with the project, putting their own money in, clubbing together, doing something together much better than they could do individually. But also being a cooperative and following the guiding principles of cooperation, it also has a fund that people in the city can access if they want to do something about fuel poverty or climate change awareness or reduce carbon emissions in some way. They can apply to the cooperative and access that fund. The fund that we're creating is so that those people that maybe can't afford to invest in or become members of the co-op, who maybe are struggling to heat their homes and put in insulation, will be able to apply to the funds and do something to help reduce their own bills. If you're in the rural parts of Scotland, you've got ample opportunity to develop renewable energies through wind. There's a lot of wind out in the highlands and surrounding areas. Obviously, if you're in a city, wind turbines are a bit harder to develop. And also, the city has a lot of people with a lot of money that they're currently saving in the bank. So there's a bit of a mismatch there. You know, rural areas, low population, not so much money. Cities, a lot of population, not so many opportunities. It engages people with the project. And it also gives somewhere a better place for people to put their money. You know, we all know that in our banks, in our savings accounts, we're getting very little interest rate. If you invest in your local cooperative, solar cooperative, then you are getting a return on your investment that you will far exceed that. And at the same time, you are helping reduce climate change and do something positive in your local community.
Can you tell me how the project is financed and how do people engage with it?
Well, what the co-op has to do is put together a share offer document. This is a formal document that people can read, and within it, it will tell you all about the project, all about the buildings that the solar panels will be on. It tells them all about the finances, how much of a return they'll get on their money, and how much might go to the community benefit fund. The hope is that everybody will get to find out about this project. Everybody in Edinburgh will get the opportunity. They'll see that this is happening in their local community, and hopefully they'll engage.
Renewable energy has people at its core. In this film, we have shown how ordinary people all across Scotland are playing a key role in supporting renewable energy developments by taking an active role in generating and managing energy supplies. But it is only possible through working together that we continue to see communities empowered to take ownership of their energy and future. Thank you for watching.
I've seen. The sky's not blue and it feels not green.